हेलो डियर फ्रेंड्स, गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू। इन दिस लेक्चर आई एम कवरिंग थ्योरी ऑफ मशीन। टॉपिक इज पावर ट्रांसमिटेड बाय वेल्ट। इन प्रीवियस टॉपिक आई हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द वेलोसिटी रेशियो ऑफ द बेल्ट ड्राइव। नाउ इन दिस टॉपिक पावर ट्रांसमिटेड बाय वेल्ट। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट द टॉपिक। सी, दिस इज अ ड्राइवर पुली and this is a driven pulley. The above slack side and bottom tight side of the belt. Now let us consider two pulley, this A and this is B, driven pulley B. Its radius R1, its radius R2, a speed of the driver pulley N1, a speed of driven pulley N2, and velocity ratio, assume velocity of belt V in meter per second. Now the effective turning force between the two pulley, that means difference between two tensions, T1 minus T2. Now work done per second equal T1 minus T2 into V. V that means velocity, T1 that means tension on tight side, T2 tension on slack side, Newton meter per second. Newton meter per second, it is also Newton meter, that means joule. Joule per second equal to watt, that means the power of SI unit of power is watt. So power transmitted equal to P equal to T1 minus T2 into V watt. If torque is exerted on the driver pulley, then torque equal to T1 minus T2 into R1. R1 that means radius of driver pulley. Torque exerted on driven pulley equal to torque T1 minus T2 into R2. This is the power transmitted formula. P equal to T1 minus T2 into V is very important, with which you help in numericals. Now one must VVI questions. Explain derivation ratio of driving tension for flat well drive. Ratio of driving tensions, that means T1 by T2, yeah, that means tension on tight side to the tension on slack side. So let us consider this is a driven pulley rotating. The tension T2 and the tension T1. Let and this is the point A and B where the belt ends, where the point of contact ends of the belt of the pulley. Angle made by arc A B equal to theta. So consider a driven pulley rotating in clockwise direction. Let T1 equal to tension in the belt on tight side and T2 equal to tension on the belt on slack side. Theta equal to angle of contact in radians, and this theta shows angle subtended by arc AB along the belt touches the pulley at the center. Now takes the free body diagram of this pulley. Let us consider a small portion P and Q of this driven pulley. If we integrate about that, then we have to find out the total tension. So first of all, take a small portion which is angle subtended by delta theta, the tension T and the frictional force applied F, and the normal force R1 applied on it. Now its free body diagram is that delta theta by 2, delta theta by 2, that means this is total overall delta theta. If this is distributed between two, then delta theta by 2 and delta theta by 2. The frictional force is F equal to mu into Rn. There are four forces applied, that means tension T on the belt P, tension T plus delta T in the belt Q, normal force Rn and frictional force F equal to mu into Rn, where mu equal to coefficient of friction between belt and pulley. Now, the derivation, resolving all the forces horizontally, that means Rn is in horizontal direction, and if is this T first horizontal and this is vertical. Horizontal, that means sin theta, vertical, that means cos theta, and T plus delta T, horizontal and vertical. Now, resolving all the forces one by one, we find Rn equal to T plus delta T sin delta theta by 2 plus T sin delta theta by 2. Here, sin delta theta by 2 is considered, but delta theta is very small angle. So, sin delta theta by 2 consider as delta theta by 2. Of not delta theta by 2 putting in equation, this we find Rn equal to T plus delta T delta theta by 2 plus T into delta theta by 2. Now, solving this and neglecting delta T into delta theta by 2, we find the equation Rn equal to T into delta theta. Now, resolving the forces vertically, we find mu into Rn equal to T plus delta T cos delta theta by 2 minus T cos delta theta by 2. In this also, cos delta theta by 2 is very small, and putting this value equal to 1, then you have to find Rn equal to delta T by mu. Now, there are two values, Rn and Rn, in equation 2nd and 4 we have to find. So, equating this equation, and we find delta T by T equal to mu into delta theta. And this equation comes for a small portion of belt, for a small portion P and Q. So, if we have to find out the whole tension on belt, then integrated delta T by 2 with T2 to T1 and mu delta theta, that means 0 to theta. So, the final result comes T1 by T2 equal to e to the power mu theta. This gives the tension of driving between the tight side and slack side if in take log condition, then 2.3 log T1 by T2 equal to mu theta. This is the relation between tight side and slack side tension in terms of coefficient of friction, and angle of contact. I hope you will understand clearly. Thank you. If you have any problem, then see this video again and again. Thank you. Now, a numerical portion based on this question. Question is that find the power transmitted by a belt running over a pulley of 600 mm diameter of 200 rpm. The coefficient of friction between the belt and pulley is 0.25, angle of lap 160 degree, and maximum tension in the belt is 2500 newton. So first of all, read this question again and again, and find out what's the data given in this question. So you have to find the belt is running over a pulley of 600 mm diameter, that means D1 diameter of pulley equal to 600 mm, that means 600 mm, that means 0.6 meter at 200 rpm. This is n, revolution per minute or rotation per minute. N is given, mu coefficient of friction is given, 0.25, theta is given, 160 degree, convert into radian, 160 degree into pi by 180, and maximum tension. Maximum tension, that means the tension on tight side, that means T1 is given 2500 Newton. So first of all, find peripheral velocity pi d n upon 60. You have to find V. Now here T2 is not given. So the formula from the ratio of tight side and slack side, 2.3 log T1 by T2 equal to mu theta. Here this T2 you have to find. When you have to find T1 and T2, you got the relation between power equal to T1 minus T2 into V. Putting the value of T1, T2 and velocity, you have to find out the final output. That means power. Thank you. And second question, this is assignment for you. A casting weighing 9 kN hangs freely from a rope which makes 2.5 tons round a drum of 300 mm diameter revolving at 20 rpm. The other end of the rope is pulled by a man. The coefficient of friction is 0.25. Determine the force required by the man and the power raised the casting. Understand this question, and this is assignment for you. One hint is given. Since there are 2.5 tons made by the rope, so angle of contact made theta equal to 2.5 into 2 pi equal to 5 radian, and find T2 and power. Thank you.